I knew you'd be back to the Mask Fan Attic once again to talk about old masks once more. That's why I kept an eye out for you. Anyway, welcome back to the attic. Tonight's mask, a real golden moldy oldie, sculpted way back around 1966 by the great makeup artist, Mr. Ellis Berman. And what is it? It's this guy, Frankenstein. That's right, or to be nitpicky about it, Frankenstein's monster, or the Frankenstein monster. Okay, now this was a Don Post Studios mask, and of course there were a number of Don Post Frankenstein masks over the years. This is merely one of them. Okay, this particular Don Post Frankenstein, sculpted by Ellis Berman in 1966, was part of a series called the 800 line. They were a little simplified as compared to the more deluxe editions. They were not the top of the line editions. They were a little cheaper, a little smaller, a little bit simplified, but still beautifully, beautifully designed and wonderfully sculpted. And it was in fact a licensed mask, and you can tell because in tiny, tiny print right there, it has etched into there UPC or Universal Pictures Corporation. Now, Universal Pictures Corporation did have the rights to the Frankenstein monster character, but not to any particular actor at this time. So this wasn't made to look exactly like Boris Karloff or Glenn Strange or any of the other actors who played Frankenstein in the movies. This is just sort of a generic amalgam of those features into what I think turned out to be very nice, very memorable, classic Frankenstein. And you know, it even has an old school look about it. It looks like it came from the 60s, which is nifty. Some of them were latex, some of them were a weird clay latex mix that they were using at the time. They were generally, this particular character was generally gray. Other characters in the series included a mummy and a wolfman and a hunchback and a Mr. Hyde. A lot of the most classic monster characters of the time. Normally I'm not a fan of masks with sculpted hair because it always looks to me like somebody threw a plate of cooked spaghetti on the monster's head. But you can get away with it better on a Frankenstein monster than you can on some masks. Now this guy was sold in the back of Famous Monsters magazine in the Captain Company advertisement section for years and years, late 60s and throughout the 70s. Often referred to as White Frankenstein. W-I-D-E, wide, you know? Now you might be looking at it and thinking it's not particularly wide, it just looks like Frankenstein. Why did they call it wide? Well, they had another mask available that was sculpted by Pat Newman and had a big frowny mouth that looked a lot like the mouth on the Carlisle zombie mask that they also made back in the day. And that Frankenstein had a thinner looking face, although when you put him side by side, he isn't really technically literally thinner. He just kind of has a thinner look about him. That one kind of became known as the thin Frankenstein and this one as the wide Frankenstein, just so there was some means of telling them apart. The thin Frankenstein was usually not gray like this. He was sort of a tealy color, kind of a turquoisey green with a little bit of blue in it, or just straight up green. I don't remember ever seeing a gray thin Frankenstein, although I have seen a greenish white Frankenstein. So these might not have all been painted exactly this color scheme with the gray, but pretty similar, pretty close. Great mask, I think. Awfully hard to find nowadays, although once in a while they do still turn up. And it's one of those masks that I always used to see when I was a kid in the back pages of the monster magazines, and so it was a wonderful thing because I would always see those pictures and think, wow, that looked like a great mask. And those of us who grew up back in the Paleozoic era kind of think of those masks with that kind of nostalgic fondness because we remember growing up with those photos. And the Wide Frankenstein by Ellis Berman from the Don Post 800 line is one of those. And until you come creeping up here again next week in the attic, I'm going to go and see if I can't find something sharp to trip over and hurt myself, which should be pretty easy up here.